What's up, everybody? Back again with another dungeon guide, and today we'll be taking a look at Hard Mode Tazavesh. I'll be going over how to unlock it and how all the bosses work on Hard Mode. If you want overall tactics for this dungeon, make sure to check my Mythic Tazavesh guide as well, where I go through every boss fight a bit more in depth. Lots to cover, so let's jump into it, starting off with how to unlock it. To do this, you need to kill the first boss of the dungeon, then make your way down the stairs to the right and round the corner. Here you'll find the questionable trader, and you need to buy the fraudulent credentials Nick from him. After this, you want to head towards the oasis, do the minigame to gain entrance to the oasis, go inside and locate Xai Darid. Here you can exchange the fraudulent Nick for a passably forged credentials Nick. Make sure to equip it and talk to Xai Darid again to get a new quest, and you're nearly there. Once you have the passably forged credentials, you can activate hard mode on a fresh dungeon reset, or whatever you want to call it. So if you're doing this in one go, you now need to exit the instance, reset it, and then go in again. Make sure you have the new Nick equipped and that you've used its on-use ability to transform into a broker. Then talk to the NPC Faye Tajid, who's right next to where you zone in to activate the hard mode, and it'll be active for the rest of the dungeon after you've done this, meaning following this, any boss you pull will be hard mode. When we tested this, it seemed to work if only one player had unlocked hard mode. Now, with that out of the way, let's hop into the boss fights. Starting with the first boss, Zo'phex the Sentinel. On hard mode, with the broker transformation from your neck, all trash and the boss will be neutral until you've talked to Zo'phex, which then activates the fight. So on hard mode, you'll be fighting the boss and the Portal Mancer mini boss you usually kill in order to spawn the main boss. On top of this, once you've engaged the boss, all the trash in the room becomes hostile, effectively reducing the space you have to do this fight on by quite a lot. Now, easiest way to do this is on pull, you want full nuke on Portal Mancer to get rid of this mini-boss. You lost, pop coolies, everything you have. Following this, you want to pull the boss into one of the corners, and any player targeted by interrogation needs to run to the far away corner, so you have time to nuke down the containment cell. And you cast this roughly every 30 seconds. If a lot of swirling swords have spawned where you tank boss, you can change corner or move a bit further up along the wall. Just keep an eye on the trash around the room so you don't pull those. Other than that, it's really just a big burn. The more the fight drags on, the less space you have and the harder the fight gets. Moving on to the Grand Menagerie. So for the hard mode mechanic, on normal mode, if you will, the 30 sec spawn timer for the second and third boss starts when the boss's before hits 40%. On hard mode, the boss timer starts when you pull the first one, so second boss will join the fight after roughly 28 seconds, and third boss after roughly 65 seconds after you've started the encounter. So individually, there's no new boss mechanics, but if your damage is on the low side, you might end up with all three of them at the same time. Individually, pretty cake. Two, three of them at the same time for a prolonged duration, and there's some really mean overlaps that you really want to avoid. So the main tactic here really is pop everything on pull and try and burn first one down really fast. So if your damage is a bit on the low side, you at least avoid the risk of having three up at the same time. Otherwise, just nuke for it. Try to utilize the gluttony debuff to nom up the volatile anima orb so your big blasters gets a damage buff. Now on to the mail room mayhem. On hard mode, whenever you pick up a unstable good, you get rooted, and you cannot remove it by shapeshifting or anything like that. So you now have to play hot potato with six boom boom boxes. What we did here was simply mark out each mail or post portal and one mark somewhat in the middle of the room. We assigned one player to always be the dunker, if you will, and one player to be the middleman, if you will. So if possible, we threw the unstable goods to the dunker, otherwise to the middleman, and that player throws it to the dunker. Keep in mind that you cannot hold more than one package at a time, so if two players throw their goods at the middleman or dunker at the same time, time, one of those will go boom boom and you will go bye bye. If possible, avoid having DPS doing the actual throwing. You can do it with like one DPS, tank, and a healer, so the other two DPSers can just focus on nuking the boss. On the flip side, if you have enough DPS, you can just burn through it and skip this, because you can still attack the boss during this, and once the mechanic starts, you have 30 seconds to finish it. So with enough DPS, you just ignore the unstable goods and blast boss. Kill it before you go boom if you can. Otherwise, go go hot potato. Next one is the Battle of the Bands, the Oasis. The new thing here on hard mode is, well, the band. The band whose instrument you just barged in and stole are now a tad upset. So the second wave of adds you get in between playing your instruments will be the band. And these band members will occasionally fixate on players that took their individual instrument. Dirt Whistle will smack the trumpet player, Evale will smack the horn player, and cast Discordant Song, which needs to be interrupted. Hips will smack the drummer and deals AoE damage. Verithian fixates the sax player and does an AoE around him that you need to run out from. And Vilt fixates the guitar player and pulls the ripcord. Now, Blizzard doesn't want to pull the ripcord, but at least they added as a boss mechanic, you cheeky. And ripcord is a frontal cone. Don't be in it. You want to have the saxophone on a ranged DPS, horn on a melee DPS, trumpet for the healer, and guitar for the tank. And as with most bands, whoever's left behind or is incapable of playing an instrument should bang on the drums. I used to play the drums. Other than that, pop coolies and nuke down hips first, you don't have to deal with his AoE. Aim Vilt away from the group to avoid smacking everyone with his frontal. Make sure to always interrupt Discordant Song and don't stand in shit on the ground. Otherwise, the rest of the encounter is the same as on normal mythic. With that said, let's check Sozami. New thing here is the upgraded triple technique, formerly known as the double technique. Previously needed to interrupt it twice within 15 seconds, now it's thrice? Three times within 10 seconds instead. So, boss will teleport away and start his cast, and it seemed to teleport as well after every interrupt. Now keep in mind, when you interrupt, the cast time doesn't reset. So say that the first interrupt was after 3 seconds, second cast is 7 seconds, etc, etc. So you want to interrupt this ASAP, but without having everyone in your party interrupting at the same time, so you can't interrupt the next two. Now, this one is a tad RNG, or can be, since he can cast this when the encounter space is split up into two or when it's split up into four, the latter being way more annoying, as sometimes the teleport runes or relocators just aren't within his area and you're screwed. Other times it requires you to jump through like three teleports to get into his area and interrupt, meaning you lose a lot of time. One thing you can do if you have any player with a blink type ability like mages or Night Fae Covenant, they can actually blink through the walls, and this should be saved for the third and last kick. So you know for sure you'll never miss that one. The first two are rather straightforward, and odds are at least one of your interrupters will be in range or can get there fairly fast with the relocators. So having the last kick somewhat guaranteed will help a lot. Another thing, if all else fails, at the cost of boss damage, you can split your DPS prior to a triple technique, meaning taking a relocator so you're on the side of the wall or walls where the boss isn't, so when he starts casting and teleports, you'll be there waiting. In theory, you could put an interrupter on each side of every wall to make sure it's interrupted, but again, you will lose a lot of boss uptime as well as healing, since you'll be LOS from both boss and healer. Last resort kind of thing. Moving on to Legion and Hylbrande. On hard mode, you'll deal with a new add and some unavoidable damage from Purifying Burst. The new add is called Stormbound Breaker, needs to be tanked, and its Lightning Nova needs to be interrupted, or it will blow up the party in a non-good way. If two casts goes off within 14 seconds, you also get stunned for 5 seconds, which is not great. Priority should be on adds all the time to not fall behind, but other than that, it's do the normal tactics, kill one more add and make sure it's interrupted. You don't have to giga nuke the add, you just have to make sure they're dead before the intermission. That's pretty much it. Next one out is Time Captain Hooktail, aka should have been a mount. Not a whole lot of new stuff here on hard mode, actually. Boss will occasionally drop an AMZ looking bubble or sphere on the ground. If players move through it, they get a stacking slow, 15% per stack. So avoid running through it and deal with the rest of the fight like you normally would. Which brings us to the last boss, which is Solia. On hard mode, two mechanics are altered a bit, which is the Collapsing Star and Hyperlight Jolt. So, for the Collapsing Star, normally you have a player run into it four times with a few seconds between each detonation. But on hard mode, the first two charges that the star has gives the player a debuff that lasts for 25 seconds, increases damage taken by the dot you get from Collapsing Star by 100%. So, ideally, you want to have your tank take the first one, then a DPS with a defensive cooldown, and after that it really doesn't matter all that much. You could potentially have tank do all four with an ungodly amount of defensive cooldowns, but it's probably safer to just split it up. Less fun though. Another thing added to this on hard mode is that anytime you remove a charge from the star, it starts pulling everyone into it. So do make sure you're away from the star when you trigger it so you don't get sucked into it and trigger another explosion too early or get additional stacks if you aren't supposed to. So keep that in mind if you're the person who has to trigger it, or overall so you're just not too close to it when somebody else triggers it. Next mechanic is the Hyperlight Jolt. On hard mode you have to hit all 5 relics or they won't despawn. Normally you could hit 3 then 2 next time and be done, but that's not possible now, they will just instantly respawn. On the flip side you want to deal with it the same way as you normally would, which is every player stands behind one relic. If every player is behind one, then all of them will get hit. Doesn't matter which relic you go to, it's just one player per relic and you're golden. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Now, like I mentioned earlier, if you want more in-depth strats on how all the bosses work, make sure to check my mythic guide for this dungeon. Now, if you have any questions at all about the hard modes, hit me up in the comments or become a patron. As a patron, you get access to the Stankie Discord where you can get help with anything raiding related. I also stream all of our progression raids on Mondays and Tuesdays, so don't forget to check that out. And don't forget the usual stuff, like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. It really helps me out. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.